awesome, man. You definitely, it's all value, mm-hmm. value. Yeah.
And so you gotta build the value, and you know, don't let the objections kind of, you know, make you raise your voice or make you frustrated. The client can see that. If you notice, every time you threw an objection at me, I kept it very calm as I was, you know, overcoming your objection. I was calm the whole time.
Right.
I wasn't raising my voice because the client can see that.
Mm-hmm.
They can see the frustration, right? And you know, sometimes it's hard. Sometimes you forget to do that when you're sitting in front of a client and they're objecting you nonstop and you're just raising your voice nonstop, you know, they can see that, right? Because you're overreacting.
Right.
But then if you actually get yourself on that and try to keep it very calm, and you have to sound very confident,
mm-hmm.
and calm, you should be able to close it.
Mm.
So
that's the big secret, huh?
That's the big secret. Just be calm, always confidence, don't be afraid to ask hard questions. Just like, hey, you care about these kids, correct?
Mm-hmm.
You love those kids, correct? You know, always use that why against them. You know, remind them why we're doing this. There's always a way to overcome any objection you ever can get.
Mm-hmm.
It's not something. And if for some reason, anyone who is having problem overcoming objections, whether our team or somebody else's team, take the, write those objections down. Write them down, because you're gonna realize later on that you're running through the same objections over and over again.
Right.
So if you write them down and call me. I'd be more than happy to go over those objections with them.
Okay, that's cool.
And wow, really? I'm like, yeah. Very quick, so what's the issue here? What exactly wanna think about? And he was like, oh, I don't know, I just wanna think about it, like, think about what exactly, about, you know, whether or not you wanna protect your family, or whether or not you wanna, you know, what exactly you wanna say? I'm like, no, that's not, I just wanna think about the price. I'm like, tell you what, we're gonna put the application in, because we don't know if you're even approved yet. Once we get an approval and all good to go, we're gonna need a voice check from you. We'll put that voice check in, once you like the price, and we'll put it in a certain date for you. Now, again, and I said the same thing over the phone, do me a favor, do your best not to cancel on yourself, because this is not about you, it's about your wife. You mm-hmm. want to make sure that your wife is covered. Unfortunately for you, her income does not cover the, you know, the funeral. She does not have coverage to cover. I can't remember the funeral home, but I'm just trying to think exactly what I said. It's not like it's not as close as possible, but you know.
Her
income does not cover whatever, you know, the final expense. So this point, we need this coverage in place to make sure that she is covered. Does mm-hmm. that make sense? And that's something, I said something about their vows. And I'm like, I'm sure when you guys got married, you vowed to her that you're gonna be taking care of her no matter what. Is that correct? Yes? Like,
yeah.
Okay. Then we're gonna make sure that she is taken care of, so that way you don't have to worry about that anymore. That makes sense? Yeah. Like, all right, so I'll tell you what, the agent over there, said the agent name obviously, she will help you with the application right now, get you done, you know, with the void check and all that, and everything will be good to go. Like, okay, no problem. He gave the phone to my agent. The agent, after she got on the phone, I'm like, all right, let's go ahead and grab a void check and get it done.
Yeah.
And it was awesome. Just, you know, but again, this is as close as possible. Like, I don't remember exactly how it happened a couple months ago.
But if it happened today, that's probably what would come out of your mouth.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So
it's the overcoming objections is pretty much always steering them back to caring about their family.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly. That's the only way you can do it.
Yeah.
So you wanna to be direct.
Yeah.
Not afraid to, am I gonna hurt the client feeling? No, who cares? You're there to not be their friend, but I mean, yeah, be friendly. Joke around, I mean, talk to people, I joke around all the time, I'm making them laugh, you know, in the same time, I'm actually there for business,
mm-hmm.
right? Like, I said in front of a bald guy, hey, what kind of shampoo do you use? I'm bald too.
Yeah.
You know, or I said in front of, you know, dog, I see dog, I'm like, oh, I'm taking the dog with me home, correct? No, you know, but jokes a little bit of jokes here and there, you know,
yeah.
you know, give them a little sense of humor as well, but then get back to business,
right.
You know, like, let them know why you're there. So I keep it into five different steps. So first step, I keep it as building a report. I don't know if you notice, I build a report with you.
Mm-hmm.
Then figure out their why, and then figure out their financial.
Mm-hmm.
Then step number four, I tell them, okay, we're gonna ask them a couple health questions and then go ahead to the application. I don't even give them quotes. And step number five is tie down. Hey, I wanna make sure this makes sense for you, right? And that's what I do, is just keep it into five different step process. And that's the simplest thing you can ever do.
Right.
Now, obviously don't stick to it, because you know, each time you probably wanna do something a little different than doing it one certain way, and that's it, because, you know, but it works.
So instead of sitting down and saying, okay, looks like we're going to be able to get you $15,000 in coverage for $87 a month, like those words don't ever come out of your mouth when you're talking to a client. No. So you ask them about their financials, and then when they tell you their financials, you figure out, you say 10% of that, right, is your expendable, or 10% of your expendable income. It looks like that's gonna be about $87 a month. So I'm gonna see what I can get you for $87 a month.
Exactly.
Right.
I don't give them all, you got three different options. Choose which one you want. No.
Right.
If I'm not running your application today, I'm not giving you a quote.
Right.
It's just my strategy. You know, I'm sitting with you, you're not giving me an application, or at least run the MIP.
Right.
If you don't like the price there, that's fine.
Right.
I went to, I have allergies to it. I went to the client home. I'm actually at this story because that happened yesterday. First one I went to, sat down with her. And I was like, she was an 83 young lady. And I was like, so ma'am, why did, like I was asking questions, and all I was doing was asking questions, because whoever asks questions wins, right? And I was like, ma'am, why do you think I'm here? Like, why I'm here today? What do you need me here for? Like, I think you're here to convince me to buy insurance. Like, I think you might got the wrong guy for that. I'm not here to convince you to buy insurance. I'm here to help you put an application and see if you even qualify. So, did that make sense? Like, oh, same thing.
Yeah.
The whole thing of it is just, it's a sales tactic.
Sure.
Makes sense? I'm like, okay. So she gave me, I was like, all I need from you is your ID. And if everything gets approved, they're gonna need a voided check. Obviously, you can hold on to that check for me. Let's make sure we can get you approved first. And now I started to ask, you know, building the rapport, the why, and all that fun stuff. But I took care of the operation of, I'm not gonna give you a check up front.
Right.
So now once we get to it, and they can tell me no, I'm like, then why the heck, you know, why I'm here then? Why did you let me stay here if I thought we were gonna do that, right?
Right.
So I made sure that I offered someone that operation up front with her, because I kind of expected she might not buy, right?
Right.
She ended up buying and ended up selling it for $3,500 Americal.
Nice.
Right? The appointment right after that, I went, pulled up the driver, was a Russian guy, and he was like, I'm gonna tell you the same thing I told the other guy before you. Okay, what is it? Like, I'm not buying anything, I'm just shopping around. I'm like, okay, no problem. What did I say? Oh, I said something about the Tahoe, that's where I brought the Tahoe is.
Yeah.
He had a Tahoe outside. And I was like, but no offense, how much are you paying on your Tahoe right here? And he said, for something. I'm like, question for you, I'm sitting outside, they haven't even let me in the house yet, right? And I'm like, are you married? Yeah. You have kids, right? Yes, I have two kids. I'm like, oh wow, I mean, I have one of my own. You love those to death, aren't you? Yeah? Okay. So, does your wife have any income? No. She's a stay-at-home mom. I'm like, okay, so you are the income provider, yeah? So, I have a question for you, but please don't get offense of that, okay? He said, yes, what is it? I'm like, you rather pay $400 and something on your Tahoe, but you're not willing to put $50 to $100 a month toward a policy that's gonna protect your family, God forbid something happens to you. Like, no, I just wanna shop around. My Tahoe, and he tried to give me excuses. And then eventually when I walked in there and we were talking about that, and I was overcoming his objection, he was like, oh, come on now, let's talk business. Like, how much it is, stuff like that. And I'm like, we are talking business. My business is to protect your family. So yes, we are talking business by talking about your family. So eventually I overcame that as well. Eventually at the end we, you know, just by just overcoming his objection, just the same way. He gave me different objection each time, like multiple objection.
Mm-hmm.
Last objection he gave me, he was like, I'm not comfortable giving my account running number. And I was like, okay, pulled up my ID card. I'm like, take a picture of this and hand me your checkbook. Let's stop the PS, please.
Yeah.
It's very exactly, he stopped the BS.
And so you actually said to him, let's stop the BS.
Yeah, I told him, stop the BS. I told him, hey, let's stop the BS. We're here to protect your family. That's my ID card to the state of Florida. Take a picture of it and hand me your checkbook, please. We need to get this done.
And he got up and got his checkbook?
He took a picture of my license and he got me credit card checkbook.
Nice.
And then we got this done right then and there for him. And it was in his garage and it was $100 a month. So right. We still made $1,400 almost.
Yeah.
$100 some change. So we made $1,400. And that's just going the extra step. Now, what he told me, I don't know who the other agent was, but the other agent, when they walked in, 2 minutes, he wasn't about to give them any information, he walked out. He's like, oh, I'm done with this. I'm walking away. I understand we're busy and we don't need any sale, but the one thing is, why I'm actually having a little bit more success, I'm willing to do that extra step.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? I'm not gonna just settle for somebody who's, I'm not giving you anything, and, or like this guy. He's like, oh, I just don't want to waste your time, but I'm not doing anything today. And guess what? All he did, that little extra step, talk him into, let me into his house, well, the garage, talk him into slowly, you know, smooth, trying mm-hmm. to be as smooth as possible. Every question he throws at me, I'm very calm. I'm watching my tone, right? I'm not overreacting or raising my voice or, no, I'm just keep it very steady and very calm the whole time. And that's actually creating a little bit of confidence.
Mm-hmm.
The guy starts to trust me a little bit more because I'm confident. I'm being very calm with this.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And that's the one thing about that. So
is that a comfortable situation where, you know, somebody's saying to you, I'm not doing anything today. You know, I told the last guy as well, I'm not doing anything today. And instead of turning and burning and getting out of there, you're staying and having an object. I mean, is that comfortable for you?
Yeah.
So you're comfortable with that?
It wasn't comfortable at first.
Right.
And that's one thing that all agents need to know. At first, it's going to be way uncomfortable, way, you know, knowing, you know, I mean, you're going to be uncomfortable. I mean, I had an agent called me without saying any names. She drove around the house and she's calling me, hey, I'm driving around the house. I don't know what to do next. I'm like, are you kidding me? You should be going there, knocking on the door and go in. You have an appointment with the gentleman, you know. So when you first start doing that, and look, I mean, I've done in-home in my background before even coming to here. So, you know, I already had my in-home when I first started here. I didn't have no problem with my in-home. I had to struggle a little bit on the phone, but my in-home was good already. The one thing is, when I started in-home in general, it's nerve-wracking. You knock on that door, you wish they're not gonna answer that door. You pray to God, I hope they're not home. Because you're nervous, right? I mean, I remember the first time I walked into, they kicked me out.
Nah.
So what I'm trying to say is, it's normal. I mean, if like if you're planning on doing 500, 600,000, 700,000 a year without a struggle, it's not for you. You're not gonna be able to make it.
Right.
And if you're, another thing I always tell agents is, if you're not making at least $25,000 to $30,000within 3 months, within 90 days, in
so $25,000 to $30,000 per within, month.
No, like $10,000 to $15,000 per month. So
right.
At least $30,000 after 90 days.
Gotcha.
In the issued paid business, then we need to either, if you're really still serious about this, we need to work on what we can improve, or you need to quit because the struggle is real.
Mm.
And a lot of people, they think when they come into here, oh, it's so easy. I'm just gonna call this family and they're gonna just let me in, mm-hmm. open arms into their homes. No, you have to go through multiple objections before you can go through there.